the genie, they kidnapped the prophet. Or has been secretly killed. Look at this conspiracy. We spent the worst night which people could ever spend. When it was dawn, we saw him coming, which means Muhammad, from the side of Harry. I see. Oh, I'm so happy the prophet is back. I was really worried that he will not show up again. He, the narrator, reported. Is that Gigi? Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
Hi, CP?
Yes, hi, this is me, CP, yeah.
Hi, this is Kimberly. Thank you for accepting my call.
All right.
First of all, I would like to thank you for all your videos because they're super helpful.
Thank you.
And I know you don't like to go off topic, but I have two questions for you.
Okay. Can we make them? Can we make them three? Because I like a trinity.
Okay. Sure, we can make them three.
All right.
Okay. So first one is Surah 3, verse 54.
Okay.
It talks about Allah being the best of deceivers. Mm. But as you taught me, that translation is sometimes very different.
Mm.
So I wanted to ask you what makar means in this verse.
Well, you know, we can go right now to the Islamic dictionary. And if the Muslims will say that Christian prince is not giving a correct translation, then they cannot say that to their own dictionary, correct?
Correct, yes.
So if we go to the Islamic dictionary, we'll find, I will type the word Makkah in the front of your eyes.
Okay.
This is in the screen, I'm typing it. Makkah. Okay.
Yes.
And this is the translation. Can you read?
Okay. Yes. One second. Part of the body between.
Maybe it's not coming yet to you.
Oh, okay. Cheat, deceive, delude, double cross, dupe. Okay.
And this is the Islamic dictionary. I have nothing to do with it. And this is not my translation. I just typed the word, and you see here the word in the front of you in the dictionary. Here, yes, translation exactly of the meaning of makar in Al-Ma'ani, English Arabic dictionary. And not only that, okay, here it says, here the Muslim, they try to make it look nicer. So they say, when it's come to the Quran, they say, God plan. But
yes, exactly.
We just said here that the word mean deceive. So God the plan is to deceive. So from the plan, okay. But here, Quran word, a plot, you see it?
Yes.
Plotted. Yes. And you know what does that mean, right?
Yes.
And here, I don't know how to say this word correctly. Arshinness, is that correct? Arshinness, deception, deceptiveness.
Yes.
It's about all is about deception.
It's all about the same.
And the fraud and etc. As you see, you know. Yeah. Fraud.
Yes. Well. The tricky thing is whenever I try to discuss this with the people around me, they always tell me, oh, the translation is bad and this.
I agree, translation is bad. The translation is not true. The translation, they should say clearly the word deception. But however, we can prove it easy. You see, yes. when we go in the Quran, and the Muslim try to give their own translation, any verse, you know, we search for it. It says here in chapter 7, verse number 99, فَآمِنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ فَلَا يَأْمَنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Okay, let us see what this verse is saying.
Okay.
Well, do they then feel secure from Allah? Plan. This is the translation. All right? But we just saw in the dictionary, it says that the word makr mean fraud and deception. So here, in order to protect the Quran, to make it look nicer, they translate the word deception as a plan. You see? So I agree, the translation is fabricated. If we change the translator, this is Shakir, let us change different translation. Let us see, English, let us see this one. Do they feel themselves secure from retribution of God? What does that mean? I don't know what this word means, actually, and I never used it before. What does that mean?
Retribution?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. My English is not as that good as well.
So now we are two. Two more we can play cards. Okay. Yes. Let's go and see Victor.
I think it's something about revenge.
Mm. Here, scheme. You see it?
Yes.
So look how they play with the word, because simply they are trying to change. I mean, why every one of them he gives us different word, different meaning?
Yeah.
Because simply they don't want to use the word deception. This is the whole point. Yeah. But you know, the word makr appear in different way in the Quran, not necessarily as makr. As an example, appear as the word yudil. Here, if you see chapter 16, verse number 26, قَدْ مَكَرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. This is the same word we are talking about.
Yes.
Okay. But you will notice here, because this is not talking about Allah, they say, those before them plotted, so Allah struck foundation of their buildings. Okay. So here you see the word makr, the same word is translated as a plotted. Unplotted is you doing something secretly, right? And, you know, deceiving people about what you want to do to them. Right. Yes. So the Muslims always, they try to fabricate the meaning. But they cannot really do a good job anyway, because all what we need to do, you know.
It's very smart.
Yeah, but it doesn't work, because the Quran says it clearly that Allah is the one who deceive everybody. If you remember, I have a debate with the Muslim Abdul, and we ask him about when he said about the hadith about Adam, that Adam, he was debating with Moses, and Moses, he said to Adam, do you blame me for what Allah he wrote for me? And he said, so Allah, he made Adam commit sin, and then Allah will punish him for the sin that he committed, you know, which is the plan of Allah. This is like, you know, so he said, well, Allah, yes, here Adam is a victim because Allah, he wanted to be known. So Allah here, he deceived Adam, you know, because he is the one who made him commit the sin. The story is very simple.
He wrote it before it happened.
Yeah, not only he wrote it, you see, when I write a scenario for you, I'm writing a scenario of two things: scenario of your fate and your how I can deceive you. You know, because here, how Adam was able to do, why he did that, because simply Allah, he made him do it. How he made him do it, he deceived him. All right.
Yeah.
The fate here is nothing but a plan of deception. So I write for you a plan which nobody can get away from it. And this plan, including how I can deceive you, so you commit sin, and then you ask me for forgiveness, and then I forgive you. All right?
Yeah.
So the story here is very clear that Allah is the deceiver, because Adam here is not the one to blame. As you see, this is Muhammad himself saying that Adam, he confuted Moses. Adam confuted Moses about this debate. And how Adam, he confuted Moses? Simply, he said to him, do you blame me? Do you blame me?
Yeah.
For action which Allah had written in my fate 40 years before my creation. So what Allah, he wrote for me, that he will deceive me, he will fool me, and he will make me do this, so later he can punish me, or I will ask for forgiveness. So Adam saying to Moses, you cannot blame me for the sin I did, because at the end of the day, this is the deception of Allah.
God's plan. You know, Allah's plan.
Yeah, this is the plan of Allah, to deceive me and to make me do so. So as you see, that the deception of Allah start from the first man and will not end anywhere until he deceive all mankind. This is the devil.
Yes.
And here, this is against the nature of God, because you see, God supposedly, he will punish you for a sin you did, not a sin he made you do.
Exactly.
For this is not justice, because if you are the one who made me commit sin, then you are going to punish me for what you made me do, and I have no choice to do or not. That's stupid. That's not fair. That's not justice, no. And this is not from God.
And it's not merciful either.
It's evil. It's pure evil. You know, like yeah. you're playing for me. I am a person who have no ability to stop you from making me doing things, and then you punish me for what I did.
Yes. You know exactly.
That is a pure evil.
It is. Well, thank you for your answer. It's very clear, and it's going to help me.
You're welcome.
I'm sure. Can I ask you just one more question?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
About Surah 5, verse 45.
5:45. Okay, what about it?
Yes. So this verse, does it say something about that forgiving is better than revenge or retaliation?
You see, you said 5:45, right?
Yes.
Okay.
This is also a question about translation and what the actual verse in Arabic means.
Yeah. First of all, here there is nothing about it's not just revenge; it's a stupid revenge. Because when you say to me, "a soul for a soul, eye for an eye, nose for a nose, ear for an ear, tooth for a tooth," shouldn't you tell us what nose you are talking about? To make it simple for you.
Yeah, that's true.
To make it simple for you.
Yeah.
If we go in the Quran, we will find. The Quran say the following: that the free for the free, and the slave for the slave, and women for the women. Chapter 2, verse 178.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we understand the other verse you are asking me about. What this is about? In the case of murder, and there's a book. It's called Muwatta Malik. It's full of cases about this. You can go and search. You will see in the Muwatta Malik says it clearly that in the case of murder. If a free man kill a slave man, the free man will not be killed. A slave man will be killed. So now what the Quran is saying, in the case of murder, free for the free, which means if a white man kill a white man, Arab man, then we kill a white man.
Yeah.
Okay. But and if a free man kill a slave man, slave will go for the slave. So here the Quran is a stupid book. So tooth for a tooth, but the tooth of who? Not my tooth. Yeah. Because if I am a free man and I am a white man, my tooth will not go. I will somebody is going to break the tooth of my slave, or I have to pay your money to the owner because he lost now his slave, he lost a tooth, you know. So the way Muslims they try to understand Muhammad here, trying to understand or trying to copy from Musa's.
Yes,
you know,
because they say this is for the Jews.
Yeah, but here actually Muhammad he practiced it for himself, not only for the Jews. He practiced it for himself. Let me show you something. Hold on. Let me let us see. We open the hadith.
Because that's what I heard someone tell me is that this verse is actually not for the Muslims, but it's for the people of the book, so talking about the Jews and not for the Muslims directly. You know,
first of all, this is very funny of him to say so, because if this is not for the Muslims and this is for the people of the book, but he forgot the one who gave that is Allah anyway, right?
Exactly. That's,
so Muslims, they aren't very naive. I mean, when they answer, sometimes I wonder if a Muslim is answering from his nose or from his toes. They don't use their brain for a second. So it doesn't matter who said that and said that to who. Still, this is your God, Allah, saying that. So this is a stupid, and as long as you agree that this is stupid, it doesn't avoid you from he saying it to the Jews or he saying it to the Christians. If we go in the hadith,
because it's the same God for them.
Yeah, because as long as it's from your God, I mean, what difference is going to make anyway? So if we go in the hadith, I just found it. It took me a little bit.
Yeah.
Here, it says Malik said. There is no retaliation healed against a free man by a slave for an injury. Do you see it?
Yes, it's appearing now,
okay.
Yes.
So if a free man broke the tooth of a slave, the Quran says, okay, tooth for a tooth. But tooth of who? Not the tooth of the free man, because there's no retaliation against the free man. You see?
Oh, wow. I haven't even looked at it that way, but yes.
The slave is killed for a free man when he intentionally murdered him. So if a slave, he killed a free man, then a slave will be killed.
Yes.
Okay. But it's not the opposite. The free man, the free man is not slain for a slave. Do you see it?
Yep.
So the tooth, tooth for tooth, eye for an eye, this is about a society of slaveries and masters. So if you are a master, you know, you will not be killed for torturing or killing a slave. And if you are a slave, you will be killed for killing a master. And in the same time, if you cause an injury for a slave, you will not be held accountable for your act. Simply, at the end of the day, the equality of law here is about between the free, the same kind. This is why the Quran here, the Quran divide the people to three kind of people. There is women and men and slaves. The women and the men, free women for a free woman, or a slave woman for a slave woman. But however, I believe here the women for women, it's about the women by gender, it's not it's which is a free. And then slave for a slave, it doesn't matter if it's a slave woman or a slave man, you know. So that there's a three generation or three level of mankind in Islam. There's a free man, he will be killed for a free man. And there's a slave will be killed for a slave. And there's a woman will be killed for a woman. And this is not just, this is stupidity.
I agree. Yeah. Right. But you know, the funny thing is that they will say, oh, this hadith is in contradiction with the Quran, so it's false.
Where? Here we go. The Quran saying that. Where? The Quran
in front of us. Well, that's the argument they always use.
No, no, they cannot. But the Quran saying, is it the Quran in front of us saying, free for the free, slave for the slave? Where is the contradiction? You know, where is the contradiction?
Yeah.
There's no contradiction. This is they can say whatever they want. You know, this is the denial is just to run away from, you know, like, you know, Muslims is the same as the ostrich bird. When this bird see a danger coming, like a wolf, etc., because she's stupid, what she do, she bury her head in the sand.
Yeah.
And then she think that because she don't see him, he don't see her.
Yes.
You know what I mean? So then the wolf, he grab her actually easier because now she is just useless. She cannot defend herself because she buried her head. So this is how silly they are. They bury their head and there's something is called, this is contradiction, we don't take it. The whole Islam is contradiction. As an example, if you don't take anything, it's contradiction to the Quran. The Quran says you do muta'ah. Why you don't say, okay, we're going to do muta'ah?
Yeah.
Hypocrites, you know?
Yeah.
So when they want, they say contradiction, in anything contradict the Quran, we will not take it. The second we say to them, what about the muta'ah? You know? Do you do 10 times breastfeeding for adult?
That's crazy.
No, no. Anyway, you know, they can say whatever they want, but people, you know, we are laughing. And people are leaving Islam, they like it or not.
No, I agree. But so last question, because you like the Trinity. So the third question.
Okay.
It's just one thing that they always give as an argument, for example, for Surah 9. Mm. They always say, oh, but that's only in that time when it was war or during wartime, and it doesn't apply to these days or to now.
Mm.
What would you say to that?
Well, first of all, even if this is for that time, that means Muhammad is an evil man. Because why you are saying that it was for that time, unless it is disgusting? Secondly, what is the proof? As long there are people who say anything contradict the Quran, we don't accept it, right? Where in the Quran it says that this is for that time?
That's a very good question.
Same time, isn't it Muhammad, he said in the hadith many places, I've been ordered to fight mankind until the say there is no God but Allah and there's no prophet but Muhammad. He didn't say the Arab around me, he didn't say it's been ordered to fight mankind. So umurtu an uqatil an-nas jami'an. Jami'an, all, not some, not a few. I have been commanded that should fight against the people till. And actually, translation is not good, because in Arabic it says jami'an, all of them, until there's nobody except saying there's no God but Allah. So the duty have nothing to do with the what time. The duty of fighting is until they declare, or declare that there's no God but Allah. You see the condition. The condition is not about this stuff fighting me. It's not about you know. It's about. And by the way, in Islam, just for those who not know, in Islam, if you don't accept Islam, you are waging war against Allah. You see, because people, they might say to you, well, in Islam it says, you know, fight those who fight you.
Yes, exactly.
But the second you say Muhammad is not a prophet, you are fighting Allah. This is why you see in the Quran, if you go to chapter 5, you know, as long as you mentioned to me chapter 5, if you go to chapter 5, verse number 51, it says, take not Christians and Jews who want to take you as a friends and protectors.
Exactly, okay? Yes.
So they are not fighting you, because there's way, there's no way they want to take you as a friend, and they are your enemy. I mean, that would be funny, right? Like, we are enemies, but you say, let us be friends. So they want to take you as a friend, but Allah reject that. Why? For they are the enemy of Allah. You know.
But then they will say, they will come up with the verse that says there's no compulsion in religion.
No, this is a verse that says the opposite. Actually, this verse saying that a group of people, they were saying, we will not let our children to convert to Islam. Muhammad, he was saying to them, you cannot force your children not to convert to Islam. Not the opposite. You see, they use verses just to fool you, when it is totally the opposite. It's Muhammad saying you cannot force your children not to convert to Islam. Otherwise, otherwise, here we go. As long as they are saying this, then they should not kill anyone, leave Islam. You know? So why somebody leave Islam and we kill him?
But that's what the translation says, though.
What translation?
That's what.
No, that one, it's okay. The translation is saying that, but if in order to understand it, we go and see the story. The story behind it is very clear, that he was telling them, you cannot force your children not to convert to Islam, but not the opposite. You know?
That's amazing.
You see, in different verses, as an example, there's tons of verses actually support what we are saying, and you know, the most important, the action of Muhammad. I mean, in chapter 8, verse number 39, what Muhammad he want? Fight them until the religion became only for Allah.
Yes, very clear.
And if they confer, if they accept Islam, then don't fight them. What is the what is the condition? Read it carefully, and fight with them until there's no more persecution. What is the persecution? By the way, it doesn't say persecution. It says fitna, fitna. This is a lie when they say persecution. Until there's no more fitna. What fitna? Fitna is people don't want to believe in God, which is Allah, or don't want to practice Islam.
Oh wow.
Okay, so
yeah,
if you accept Islam, that's it. We don't fight you. What is the reason for the war? The verse saying that clearly. Until, you know, and they say it in the translation. Let us change the translator, and you will see how the translation change. Just to show you the lies Muslims they do. This is translation of Shakir. Let us go to translation English translation. What is that? I never heard of the translation. It's called translation. Oh, this is a different language. Hold on. I don't know what is that. Okay, let's see. Yusuf Ali. Let us say Yusuf Ali.
Yes.
Okay. Until there's no tomblet. What tomblet mean?
Tomblet.
Let me search.
I think my screen is very is late a little bit.
I will search Google. Okay. Confused. Until there's no confusion, all the here never.
Is it chaos or something?
Chaos, yeah, chaos. So here we go. Yeah. So the chaos, okay. Why would they chaos? Because there's people who have different belief, and we would not allow that. So it's not a persecution, as etc. And here he add the word or oppression, which is not really exist in the Quran. There's no word oppression exists here. They added, and then and there prevail justice and faith of Allah altogether and everywhere. So the fact it's the opposite, actually. The Muslim, they are saying that the other one is under persecution, but the fact they are persecuting others and they are forcing themselves on others until we fight them, until there is no religion but Islam.
Yes,
you know, and each time you change the translator, you will see a different translation, different words, different meaning, because Muslims look at this. This is a different translation. Look how the translation changed suddenly. So fight them till all oppositions end. Do you see it?
Yeah. So they make it look like they are how opposition them and they have to defend them.
Yeah. How opposition was oppression.
Yeah.
If I oppose you in your religion, this is not oppression for you.
No.
So fight them till there is all opposition end and obedience is all holy God to Allah. Okay, so and by the way, it says here the religion will be all became to Allah. So everybody became Muslim. So we fight them until everybody became a Muslim. If we go in the hadith, they should support that with one more hadith. You will see in this hadith as an example, and that will explain Islam to us. Quran chapter 3, verse 110, it says that the best of mankind are the Muslims. Why they are the best of mankind? Because simply they have a duty. And the duty is, read with me carefully. The verse, you true Muslims are the best people ever raised for mankind. Means the best of the people for the people as you bring them with the chain on their necks till they embrace Islam.
Wow.
Can we make it more clear more than this?
No.
So this is the duty. It's not them fighting you. You have a duty as a Muslim to fight them and bring them. How somebody will come to you with the chain around his neck unless you go conquer him, enslave him, torture him, because the slavery is about you being surrendering for somebody and you became his slave. As simple as that.
Yeah.
And he put a leech on your neck. And that is supposedly a holy duty for every Muslim. To force you to convert to Islam. And actually, this is how they converted a lot of people. You know? Because now you are a slave and they will torture you because they will torture you more. So if you want us to be merciful for you as a slave, we'll convert to Islam. We will treat you better than a slave is not a Muslim.
Yeah.
Because now you will have more rights.